Today, we're going to talk about the RTLS, or the Real-Time Locating System. So, are you ready? Let's go!
The Real-Time Locating Systems are local systems used for the identification and tracking of the location of assets or persons in real or near real-time. The systems consist of specialized fixed readers, or also known as location sensors, receiving wireless signals from uniquely tagged objects of interest or person to determine whether the tagged entities are located within a building or outdoor space. In hospitals, RTLS is significantly linked to perceived efficiency and patient satisfaction. These systems were found to improve patient safety by preventing patient elopement through access control, video surveillance, and other electronic security and building technology. Also, these systems have the ability to protect infants from being abducted and prevent improper mother and baby matching using alerts and security systems or door lock integration. The use of RTLS in the operating rooms led to a rise in patients, family members, and friends' satisfaction as they can receive updates sent directly to their smartphones, which includes surgical updates in the patient's location, progression through the operative process, and visitation readiness. RTLS are also used in ensuring the right identification of each patient and their corresponding medical data anywhere in the hospital, guaranteeing that appropriate actions are being granted to the right persons, such as drug administration, surgical procedures, and etc., regardless of the time and place. Identifying lab samples like blood, urine, exudates, biopsies, and etc., verifying the authenticity and origin of drug, checking their status and expiry dates while they are being moved to the different departments and sections in the hospital. RTLS were found to improve patient care quality and organizational revenue by increasing efficiencies through reduced time and costs spent in locating assets, equipments, patients, and staff. With the use of RTLS, users experience less theft, equipment hoarding, and rental and late return fees for important hospital equipment. This improved asset and equipment visibility through the use of RTLS often leads to improved utilization and a return on investment in less than a year. By the use of RTLS in locating IVF pumps, one can track whether staff members are complying with regulations regarding proper disinfection between uses by different patients. In addition, RTLS can be used to track staff members' compliance with the hand hygiene protocol in the hospitals, as it can be used as a low-cost method for recording when staff members use hand sanitation stations before and after they enter and leave rooms and wards. Next, RTLS can improve the safety of staff and nurses by giving them the means to request emergency assistance during crisis situations. Also, by wearing the RTLS tags or badges, the nurse's location during the crisis situation will be revealed that will result in a fast response of security personnel. In 2006, RTLS was used in detecting and tracking potential severe acute respiratory syndrome or SARS cases in one hospital in Taiwan. RTLS use in long-term care facilities. In nursing homes or long-term care facilities, RTLS are mainly used to track patients or residents in the case of wandering behavior. RTLS can make alerts letting staff and nurses know if a patient has wandered into an area where they aren't supposed to be, such as the laundry room, the dirty utility room, or etc., where harmful chemicals are located. This is crucial when giving care to patients with dementia or Alzheimer's disease. It was found that losing items and monitoring the residents' use of assistive devices are the challenges in nursing homes. RTLS can effectively provide solutions to this problem.
Now that you know a lot about the use of RTLS in the healthcare facilities, let's explore more about the limitations of this technology.
An RTLS can be realized using different technologies, including light, camera vision, infrared or IR, sound, ultrasound, Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, radio frequency identification, or RFID, wherein RFID tags can either be active with a small power supply to send out a signal covering a range of up to 100 meters, or passive with no power supply and activated by a scanning signal, which limits their range of detection to less than a meter. Zigbee, ultra wideband or UWB, GPS or global positioning system, and cellular, and etc. Different technologies use different approaches, and each method supports different applications or solves a slightly different problem while introducing its own limitations. For example, an infrared requires a clear line of sight for the tags and sensors to communicate. So if a badge worn by a patient is covered by a blanket or flipped around, the system might momentarily lose track of the patient. Next, the passive RFID technology was considered to be not the best for indoor location because it doesn't give a precise location of the tag and have a very short reach, which means that in order to cover a big area with passive RFID, a facility has to have lots of hardware or antennas when configuring its system, which makes this system expensive. This is according to Paiva, Brito, and Leiva Marcon, 2018, page 3, and Contact, 2017. The Bluetooth Low Energy, or BLE, or active RFID equipment, is now replacing the passive RFID system as part of the RTLS evolution. BLE has a far longer reach than the RFID or passive RFID system, which means that BLE has a far longer reach than the passive RFID system, which means that the facility only needs few antennas when configuring a system, therefore a less expensive system. In addition, although proven to be high cost due to the need of having large numbers of routers, being not easy to get a precise indoor location, and considering that removing or simply changing the location of a router has a different impact on the RSSI, or Received Signal Strength Indicator Map, Wi-Fi can also be used for the purpose of indoor location because it is present in almost every place. It is recommended that the use of blended RTLS solutions that incorporate complementary technologies such as IR or infrared and RFID can deliver levels of precision and flexibility that are unachievable by any single competing technology. In conclusion, in healthcare settings, the RTLS was found to promote patient and caregiver safety and security, increase patient and family satisfaction, staff efficiency, hand washing and disinfection protocol compliance, and increase organizational revenue. Furthermore, it is suggested that the choice of RTLS technology must be carefully made, if not properly matched to the intended application of the care facility's physical environment, budget, and future expansion plans, technology and hardware may not work well despite all its merits. I hope you learned a lot about RTLS today. That's all, and thank you so much.